On Thursday, 29 September, there was chaos at Parliament as members elected the yellow representatives. This followed claims by Aringa South Member of Parliament, Alion York Odiria, that there was vote rigging.
I've got one clear the remaining three. Clear the remaining three boxes. Media, take note.
You have a point.
Media, take note. I am ready to die for the truth. Clear those boxes. Clear them.
Amidst the scuffle, Odria punched one of the police officers who was later identified as Assistant Superintendent of Police, Alex Senge. Addressing the media today, police spokesperson Fred Enanga revealed that they have issued criminal summons against the legislator. Enanga adds that it was improper for the MP to behave in such a way. Besides, he caused some serious injuries to the police officer.
You all witnessed how he violently grabbed the ballot box and took it to the main building in complete disregard of the parliamentary electoral procedures. He was, however, stopped by the OC of Parliament and officers attached to the office of the Sergeant at Arms. So for us, the best way to understand his motive for the unprovoked assault is to listen to him. And the first step also towards justice for the senseless act of violence against the officer is us reducing the statement of the Honourable MP into a written statement.
Meanwhile, police have urged members of the public to desist from using charcoal stoves or any carbon-emitting substances in an enclosed place, as this may lead to carbon monoxide poisoning. The warning follows the death of a female police officer and her daughter at Nsambya Police Barracks.
That we've come to caution individuals and groups of persons on how to protect themselves against carbon monoxide. Some of these tips are very crucial, and one of them is to avoid using a charcoal stove, charcoal grill, a lantern, or portable camping stove inside your room, especially at night.
From the Kampala Metropolitan, the police are investigating the murder of Susan Alwen, a city lawyer working with Liberty General Insurance. It is alleged that the deceased was attacked by thugs as she stopped to buy meat along Chiwatle Nalia Road. They pounced on her. She was later rushed to Mulago Hospital, where she was pronounced dead.
She had stopped along one of the supermarkets at Chiwatle Nalia Road to buy some meat. He alleges that they were in touch and he was waiting for the loved one so that they can go home together. But unfortunately, he kept on calling and the phone calls weren't going through. So we have started investigating this matter as a case of aggravated robbery, where unspecified amounts of money and phones were taken from the deceased. We have identified one suspect. We shall give you more information upon his arrest.
Also, the police and the army have launched investigations into one incident where unknown gunmen in military-like attires kidnapped a Pakistani businessman and robbed him of his cash. This follows a viral video where the gunmen were seen forcing the businessman into a private car before they sped off. Meanwhile, the police are continuing with their nationwide operations to crack down on vandalism of electricity installations, as the deputy police spokesperson, Claire Nabaka, explained.
Cases that we have handled so far at 57 cases that have been reported countrywide, we have 28 that have already appeared in court. We already have 6 convictions, and then 23 are still undergoing investigations.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.